Everybody, it's Catherine. Welcome to my channel where I like to talk all things fragrance and beauty. So tonight has been, oh wait, I forgot. Oh, some of y'all think that I'm boring. That lively enough for you? Anyway. One of the very first fragrance reviews I did, I'll link it right up here, was for Baccarat Rouge 540. It's one of my favorite fragrances, one of my best friend Jill's favorite fragrances. As beautiful as Baccarat Rouge 540 by Maison Francis Kurkdjian is, it also has a pretty high price point. Not everybody out there can afford to drop that kind of money on a bottle of fragrance, myself included. So I pay attention when fragrance reviewers talk about dupes for Baccarat Rouge 540. One of those is Jeremy Fragrance. He goes on and on about how Ariana Grande, Cloud, is a dupe for Baccarat Rouge 540. So my first thinking for this video was just to compare the two. But in my onslaught of trying perfumes here lately, I found a couple that I will say are similar to Baccarat Rouge 540. Not dupes per se, because they're not, I mean, Baccarat Rouge 540 is an elegant, beautiful fragrance that would be difficult to be duplicated per se, but these are similar and, you know, perhaps a more reasonable price point for a bottle of perfume. So to start off, let's discuss Baccarat Rouge 540. Again, I'm going to link the video that I did originally if you want more of an in-depth detail on that particular fragrance. This is going to be pretty brief. Baccarat Rouge 540 is considered an amber floral fragrance. It was created in 2015, obviously by Maison Francis Kurkdjian. The top notes are saffron and jasmine, middle notes amberwood and ambergris, base notes fir, resin, and cedar. We'll start off in comparison with is Ariana Grande's Cloud. As Jeremy Fragrance says, is one of Baccarat Rouge 540's dupes. So again, I mentioned this before, but a lot of times I'll just like to get a roller ball of the fragrance if the fragrance comes in a roller ball version. As I've been told, I'm a fickle frag. I have troubles committing to purchasing full bottles of perfume because there just are too many out there that I enjoy that I want to be able to explore and enjoy. Get like one of the discovery sets or the roller balls, then you can enjoy it. Usually by the time my roller ball is out, I'm on to another fragrance anyway. So anyway, little tip there if you also like to dabble in a lot of different perfumes or colognes. Unfortunately, a lot of colognes don't come in the roller ball version, so sorry there. But Ariana Grande Cloud is a 2018 fragrance considered a floral, fruity gourmand created by Clement Gavary. Anyway, the top notes of Cloud are lavender, pear, and bergamot. Middle notes whipped cream, praline, coconut, and vanilla orchid. And the base notes musk and woody notes. In comparing the notes alone to Baccarat Rouge 540, really the only thing that they have in similar are the base notes of Ariana Grande have those woody notes, and the base note of 540 is the cedar wood, the resin, the fir, the amber wood. So you have that. In purely olfactory comparison, Ariana Grande is an enjoyable fragrance. It's sweet, very girly. I can understand how the two of them could be compared. However, I don't think if I were to wear Ariana Grande that anybody would probably confuse it for Baccarat Rouge 540. And they do smell similar, but they are nowhere near the same. Upon initial spray of the two, it is comparable. The longer you wear Ariana Grande Cloud, it turns much more cotton candy sweet. Versus Baccarat Rouge 540 becomes a bit more, the dry down is much more woodsy. So I think over time, the two differ more and more, but initial first half an hour maybe, they do smell pretty similar. So again, that was Ariana Grande Cloud, which is available at Ulta. The rollerball I think was like $30. So it's a very reasonable price for a perfume. And like I said, it's not necessarily less desirable, it's just different. if you enjoy Baccarat Rouge 540, but you want a sweeter version, more cotton candy, more coconut, more whipped cream, go this route. It's much more favorable for your pocketbook. So no, I don't really agree per se with Mr. Jeremy Fragrance, though I do appreciate him, his humor, and his entertaining qualities. So next on the list, we'll go back, we'll do another friendly on the pocketbook fragrance. So this one actually I have had for quite some time. It was one of my favorite fragrances. As you can see, I put a decent dent in it. This one is Burberry Her. It also has very much the same, I'll say, temperament as Baccarat Rouge 540. As I said in my Baccarat Rouge 540 video, 540 is very synthetic, but not in a bad way. It's not necessarily bad to be synthetic. It's Maison Francis Kurkdjian is an artist of all fragrances, and the way that he wove the components of the fragrance makes it an extremely enticing perfume. It just is synthetic in nature. You can't necessarily identify any of the components of the perfume when experiencing it. And Burberry Her is much the same way. It again has that alluring quality to Baccarat Rouge 540, where it's just, you know, one of those fragrances you can't stop smelling, but you don't necessarily identify any of the scents that you are smelling. It just kind of has that je ne sais quoi. I can totally see how the two would smell similar, as that Maison Francis Kurkdjian was the designer of Burberry Her. He is the nose behind that perfume. It was created, again, 2018, so just like Ariana Grande's Cloud. Coincidence? Maybe, maybe not. Either way, the notes in Burberry Her are quite extensive. Top notes in Burberry Her include strawberry, raspberry, blackberry, sour cherry, black currant, mandarin orange, and lemon. Mid notes are violet and jasmine. Base notes, musk, vanilla, oak moss, cashmeran, patchouli, amber, and woody notes. Her is considered a floral fruity gourmand. It's really ironic. Cloud and Burberry Her, both created in 2018, both considered floral fruity gourmand fragrances. I just think that's just a little bit too much of a coincidence. Anyway, so in comparison to the original 540, you have the woody notes again, which again is the same as the Ariana Grande Cloud. Other than that, they really have no other notes in common. Again, Burberry Her is a very enjoyable fragrance, one of my go-tos prior to starting this fragrance channel and experiencing all the fragrances that I have recently. Again, very similar to Baccarat Rouge 540. Would I call it a dupe? Probably not. If you're looking for a similar fragrance to Baccarat Rouge 540 without the high price point, and you don't want whipped creamy coconut aspect of the Ariana Grande, maybe you just feel iffy about wearing a fragrance by Ariana Grande, I would go the Burberry Her route. Lastly, the last comparison, again, not a dupe, but a comparison, would be Bond No. 9's Tribeca. Initially, upon spraying these two perfumes, they do not smell similar at all. To be honest, the initial spray of Tribeca on me, I enjoyed like the first 5 minutes, and then all of a sudden it becomes this bitter, I can't even place it, just like a bitter synthetic scent on me. But then after I've worn it and you get the dry down starts to come out more, it is extremely similar to Baccarat Rouge 540. It has that same je ne sais quoi, just that lovely scent with those, just that same kind of feel as Baccarat Rouge 540. But again, you gotta wait for the dry down for the Tribeca to bring that out. And I do wonder if Tribeca just doesn't, I have heard such wonderful reviews on it, that I wonder if it just doesn't smell. Different fragrances respond differently on people based on their own personal chemistries. So I just wonder if Tribeca just isn't a good fit for me personally, which is unfortunate because, like I said, I have heard beautiful, beautiful reviews on the fragrance. Again, it is a higher price point fragrance, so that's something to consider. Tribeca, considered a woody amber vanilla fragrance created by Michael Amarak in 2020. So the top notes to Tribeca are cacao, hazelnut, middle notes, jasmine, sandbach, and cedar, base notes, ambroxan, caramel, and moss. In terms of 540, they both have the cedar in common. They both have the jasmine in common. So really, Tribeca and 540 have the most in common with those two notes. However, in 540, jasmine's the top note, and cedar's the base note, and jasmine and cedar are both in the middle notes of Tribeca. So, again, a lovely scent, not necessarily the best on me, but dry down, extremely similar to 540. Again, one of the more pricey of this these four fragrances. Again, least expensive would probably be Ariana Grande, then Burberry Her, Tribeca, and Maison Francis Kirk Dijon. Could be about even depending on what size or if you get the 540 extra. So different things to consider. Another thing, if you are a bit more price conscious, another idea, if you want the real thing, is to get, if you go to the Maison Francis Kirk Dijon website, you can get smaller versions. So I got both the 540 and the 540 extra. It was kind of pricey for even this amount, but it's a little bit more reasonable, especially if you like the multitude of fragrances that I do. It comes in like a travel type bottle, and this is 11 milliliter. You could also then extend the fragrance's life or reapply with the lotion. So I use the body cream on my legs and then apply the perfume, and then you know, especially during the summer when your body gets more warm, it releases more of the fragrances, and so you don't need to reapply the perfume as much. So a little tip there if you do want to wear the real thing but save your money a bit. Niche perfumery, I think perfumes are a version of art, and so being such, I don't necessarily agree with copying a fragrance to create a dupe. It'd be like, you know, an artist doing a knockoff of the Mona Lisa, and every, oh no, no, you know, but when it comes to fashion, perfume, or even cosmetics, somehow dupes and lesser expensive versions are acceptable. We all can't afford the real thing, and I understand that. But I guess that is why I also appreciate these fragrances, because they're not necessarily identical, but they are similar. So you're not buying a copied version, it's just a very similar version. My two cents there. My name is Catherine. Thanks for stopping by my channel. If you are a return guest, thanks. I appreciate the loyalty. If you are a new guest, welcome. Thanks for visiting. Please make sure to hit subscribe so you can join my family of fellow fragrance and or cosmetic beauty lovers. You can keep up when I post new videos. Also make sure to hit the notification bell so you can be alerted as soon as my videos post. I work in education for my day job, so technically I have the next month or so off, aside from some administrative type planning duties, but I am going to try to create and post more videos in the next coming months, so please stay tuned. More reason to hit that subscribe button so you can stay informed. I hope y'all are doing well and having a great start to your summer. Okay, thanks. Bye-bye. So, tonight has been a long time video. Oops. Tonight I'm gonna do a video.